My name is Matt Iseman, and I'm the one who's producing, directing, writing, and starring in this film that you're about to watch. I wear the many hats.
Well, it's the most serious challenge to our position
of the positions that I hold, and as such, I felt it prudent to take this time at the beginning of the film to issue a stern warning concerning the watching of this film. We'd like to ask that all people who will watch this film will take some proper safety precautions to ensure that their film watching experience is a pleasant one. First, we'd like to ask that protective eyewear be worn.
Adds a graphic interface to DOS. Truly surprised most people by how.
As you can see, protective eyewear stops any blows to the eyes, hence the name protective eyewear. We also ask that you wear a weight belt to ensure that no back injuries are incurred, as back injuries are one of the most common injuries while watching films. The weight belt is of utmost importance. But the foremost item of safety equipment is the helmet. The protective eye gear may be placed on the outside of the helmet as such. If you are unable to put the protective eye gear on yourself, please ask for assistance from one of our helpers. Now, when you're ready to watch the film, please restart the film and enjoy. Thank you.
Well, Phil, thanks for coming. I'm going to let you go before it's time for the second decade anniversary of the computer. Bill Gates of Microsoft Corporation.
But as long as I'm here, one quick impression. Just a minute!
This anatomical man has joined transvestites, transsexuals,
sitting in Matt Iseman's basement playroom, and we're shooting this show live. This is live. This is not pre-recorded television. We're actually here right now to go to watch. And tonight we're going to talk about Matt Iseman. Yeah, well, you know, that's what happens when you have your own show. You can talk about it yourself all you want. And, well, I think the most pressing topic is... Excuse my microphone. The most pressing topic right now is Matt's journey to... Lovely! South Africa! Let's get up. Well,
human and animal waste.
So much for the focus. Anyway, that's correct. I am taking a journey to the land of South Africa. Right by Lesotho and Swaziland, two other popular vacation spots. Anyway, I just thought we'd take this time to learn a little bit more about the place where I'm going to be going. So, first off, we will consult the handy Bullets South Africa Travel Guide. Well, let's see what it has to say. South Africa is located in the southern portion of Africa, hence the name implying said location geographically in relation to the rest of Africa in the southern portion of said continent is South Africa located there. So, what else does it have to say about the land to which I am journeying in not so long of a time now? South Africa is the number one location of births. That's right. Minor technical difficulties which have been overcome. How's that for an entrance? Don't worry, I'm not hurt. I'm afraid, in consulting the tape, that last fact may have been misrepresented. The actual fact was South Africa is the number one spot for births of South Africans, not births total. But it is the number one spot for, coincidentally actually, the number one spot for births of people of South African. Anyway, so those are just a few facts about South Africa. The really a fascinating land, the cultures, quite interesting. I'm looking forward to studying it and becoming more familiar with the area. But I have taken the time to learn the South African anthem, not as well known as some of the other ones, such as O Canada or the Star Spangled Banner, or even Russia's, which, but anyway, I this is a musical show. It's a family variety show. The Matt Iseman Show is, it's whatever the heck, see, we're keeping it family-oriented, whatever I want it to be, and right now I think it's gonna take a musical tilt, and I'm gonna play for you at home the South African anthem, so let's sit back and take a listen to it. We'd like to thank Kawhi for the keyboard. Lovely setup, isn't it? It's a very, very complex tune, reflecting the complex situation in the nation. I think that no anthem better represents its country than South Africa's. But enough of that build up. Here we will actually play the anthem in just a moment. Just kidding. Africa! Africa! You're in the southern part of Africa! That's why they call you South Africa! Yes! We're not actually sure if That is the way it was meant to be played, but it was a personal interpretation of a song that I've really come to love since I've begun my studies of South Africa, minutes ago.
From such humble beginnings would grow a show whose popularity would become so widespread that governments in nations such as Hungary and New Zealand would declare national holidays to allow people to watch the show in the proper environment. But enough of that. Anyway, let's take a look at some more highlights.
New headphones. So I can rock out. And also, my Galaxians game.
That they say he kept with him all the time have now disappeared. And his brother, a musician in Northern Virginia, says...
I need new batteries. I'm also going to take along some binoculars. You just can't feel for better viewing. Well, I'm getting a little bit bored with my show, so we're going to go to commercial. Hello, my name is Aguero Latore. No, I did not just sneeze. This is my mustache. I'm here to talk to you today about something very important. Windows. Clean windows can make our house look so much better. You'll say, Guido, how'd I go so long without having to clean windows? So, I'm here today to tell you how to get a new clean windows. And that's with Guido Ettore products, such as my squeegee. If you will watch to that monthly, now you see that window's clean enough for a white glove test. Try our new Ettore products. Oh boy, everybody loves them. Thank you. That's right, I'm back. Thanks to Mr. Ettore for that rousing endorsement of his own products. But we'd like to ask that you do patronize all our sponsors because they keep us on the air and funded. The next part of the show is it's the next part of the show, and we're going to go to it pretty soon, and you can tell this is the lively portion of the show, a little bit of glitz and glamour here. This is really the Vegas part of the show. We're going to cut to the next part, which is a action movie, an inspirational movie. I've really watched it on a daily basis. It really provides meaning and balance in my life, and I hope it will for you too. So let's roll the film up there in the booth. Action. What's that? Someone needs an assistance. I will help them. Going to help them. You get that chance. Kung Fu Man. You have a knife. But the knife cannot stop Kung Fu Man. I'm going to stab you, Kung Fu Man. I'm going to stab you. You cannot stop Kung Fu Man. I'm going to stab you. You gotta stab me. You gotta stab me. You gotta stab me. You gotta hurt me. Hey, I want to do anything. I am Kung Fu Man. You gotta challenge me. You gotta be Kung Fu Man. You will. Who was that? Now 7-bit toy was. Now I'm a Kung Fu Man. Eyes like steel, cold and hard. It's a bad man. It's a legend around these parts. Name a Kung Fu Man. It's a beautiful movie.
what he prefers to stay out of.
Good flick, huh?
Oh, hi! Hi! Oh, hi!
They're having some rough, the dog. She stepped on my model. Well, Ruff wasn't as thrilled about the Matt Eisman show as I was. There she is again, you can hear her. That's not me. That's Ruff. So, thanks to those of you at home, we're hearing him play.
The next segment of the show is entitled, What I Would Do If I Were King. And just you sit back and watch.
The trend has been starting really back in the mid-60s, and the trend has gone on through decades and decades to the point where we're living in an extremely violent society. I think really that we need to see more in the 90s, in fact, the first serial killer of any
Yes. Hello, it's Fair King Matt.
In the 90s, rather, we're going to be seeing more women involved.
Yes. If I were king, every meal would be eaten at a fast food place, such as McDonald's, and the only movies on cable would be Rocky or Rambo or any Schwarzenegger flick. Also, Steven Seagal and Jean-Claude Van Damme could be shown late at night. If I were king, we would all take a class on video games and Nintendo, and I would be very happy, and the women would all be... I could get into trouble on this one, so I'll just say the women would all be very pretty, as they are now. Very diplomatic. What else would I do? I would make sure that my dog responded to her name if I were a king. If I were a king, I would also give myself all the money so I would never have to work, and a very nice car as well. And, I would also be the judge of the Miss King contest, which would be similar to the Miss Universe contest, only bigger, and I would be the judge, and if I were king. Well, that's about it. So, that's the way it would be if I were king. Of course, that's just an artist's rendition, but, I mean, if I were actually king, it could be a lot different. We don't really know. I mean, I'm not the king. If I were the king, then who would be the prince, the jack? And if I were the king, would the ace be high or low? I mean, if it were high, then, you know, who's to say that the ace wouldn't make the rules, and then I would just be trumped, and then where would I go? You know, I mean, it's Atlantic City's a lovely place, but I don't like girls named Ivana, and I rarely ride bicycles, rarely, if ever, and tricycles, yes, but no bicycles, unicycle on occasion, but I don't like bicycles, not a bit.
Season, the network has decided to greatly enlarge our budget, and hence the new studio with a lot of new tricks I think you're really going to enjoy. However, we are still not completely free of technical glitches, so problems still may arise, but I want you to know it's not my fault, so don't blame me. Anyway, like I said, we are high budget now. We can do things that we only dreamed of doing before. Here at the Matt Eisman Show. And one of them is to really just waste money wantonly with no regard for any financial concerns whatsoever. And I think there's no better way to do that than the way, it's really a maybe not started, but really, I think, cemented and exemplified with the Dukes of Hazzard, and that is, of course, the smashing of cars. So, without further ado, let's cut to some car smashing.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Iseman International Stadium, site of today's monster truck event! That's right, ladies and gentlemen, these beautiful pieces of American machinery that you see before you are going to be smashed to bits by the world's biggest monster truck. No one has actually seen the new truck. It has been secretly hidden while it has been constructed, and today is its grand unveiling. So without further ado, let's cut to some smashing. That's right, folks. Car smashing at its best. We understand the new car's name is the Magnum. And boy, oh boy, is it big. Folks, it's never been even seen. It's so big. That's how big it is. Here we are in the Goodyear blimp, taking a look at the Iseman Stadium infield. There are the cars. We understand the Magnum has entered the stadium and is prepared to crush some cars. That's right. Here it comes, folks. Oh, my God. Look at this. Oh, my God. Look at that. Oh, Jesus. Oh, Jesus. Oh, it's spinning up. It looks stuck. Oh, I can't move. Oh, my God. No, I thought they'd see it like this. Oh, look at that. It's so big. People are trapped. They're running for their lives. Ah. Holy cow, folks, it's unbelievable! Look at those cars, they've been destroyed! Oh my God, what a wanton waste of money! Oh my God, here comes the Magnum back for another pass, look at that! Ah, it's chewing them up again! Ah, it's unbelievable! This is crazy! Folks, this truck is so big you can barely see it. Look at it go. Oh my God. It wants another pass, folks. It looks like it's having a little trouble with this deep pile of carpet that they've just put down on the Iseman Stadium infield. But oh God, look at that. Oh, it just tore him up. Now in reverse. Oh, jeez. No one's ever seen anything like this. Oh my God. It's crushing him. People are being killed. This is the most ruthless display of monster truck cars and money wasting I've ever seen. And thanks to the Matt Iseman Show for providing it to us. Wasn't that impressive, folks? That's right. Monster car crushing. Who could believe it?
Now, I'm here to show a special effect that we can do with our new studio monitor. And that is picture within picture. In picture, see, there I am. Touching myself. It's one of those infinite regression type things. Pretty cool stuff. Anyway, you know, this show has really been a huge hit in many places, including Cleveland and Japan. We've gotten very high ratings, and we hope you're all enjoying the show tonight. We think it's a good one, and anyway, just sit back and continue to enjoy the show. We've got much more to come, so don't go away. You know, folks, there's something that's really disappointed me, and that is I didn't have these glasses to do the Terminator impersonation. I think it really would have added to it. But, you know, I'm not going to go back and re-record it, so too bad. Are you a wild guy, or do you just want to look like one? Either way, pick up the phone and call now, the Wild Line, and you too can be a wild guy just like me. That's right, here in Colorado, wild guys get to wear wild clothes like this and do wild things like this. Woo! As you can see, the fun never stops when you're a wild guy. So pick up the phone and call now, Wild Guys. Hi, Wild Guys. I want to be a wild guy too. It's that easy. And you too will be joining in the Wild Guy fun. Try it yourself.
Woo! That's right, folks. Wild guys. Now that was definitely filler. But, again, I love that really, you know, now it's really good. I think you could probably pick me up right there. Hi! Anyway, there is no end to the technical magic we can do. Right now I'd like to show, you know, a more sensitive and contemplative side of myself. And I'd just like to share it with you at home. Well, it has been fun, but I'm really tired of the whole project, so I think I'm going to end it here, mercifully, you might add. Better not, though. I'd just like to say I've really had a good time these past days, seen tragedies, it's seen triumphs. But it's really just... It's been a cathartic experience. Cathartic? Would it be cathartic? Well, it's been a cleansing experience for me, and I really feel that I can go on with my life now, having left behind a piece of me. I wouldn't do it any other way if I had to do it all over again. So, goodbye. To all you people at home, thank you for making the Matt Iseman Show the number one rated program in the land for so long. And really, the letters, the outpouring of emotions really meant so much to me. And I hope I, in turn, was able to give something to you. So with that, I will say my final good night as the host of the Matt Iseman Show. Thank you. Hi. I'd like to take this time to personalize this tape for a girl who means so much to me. She's out there in the audience tonight, and I know she's watching, thinking of me, and I'm thinking of her. She's a very special girl. She just... really livened my life, and her name is
Laura Keatley.
You know, she's really meant so much to me. She's been everything I could have hoped for and everything I could have dreamed of. And that's why tonight,
Laura Keatley,
I would just like to take this opportunity to say you're one of the nicest girls I've ever met, and a very good friend. All your special talents, like
tennis, cooking, lab technician,
make you the person that I find so special and attractive. And I just can't imagine my life without you. But anyway, you get my drift. No, isn't it amazing what you can do with video cameras? But anyway, that last segment was a joke. This tape really is for...
It's for you, Laura.
No,
It's for whoever wants to watch it, but I mean, I'm sending it to you. You can distribute it as you see fit, but as long as I get a cut of the royalties, I'm fine. So anyway, this concludes my tape, and I'd like to work on it for like another week and a half and just dedicate myself to it, but I've got other things to do, like sleep and eat and watch TV and play Nintendo, so that's too bad. But no, I gotta send it so you can get it. But let's see. Just to get you up to date on my life, which is really stupid because I'll probably talk to you before, like after I send this tape, but before you get it, so you'll already be updated. But you know, there's just not much else. I'm gonna go play golf at Cherry Hills Country Club, and I'm gonna go to work tomorrow and wash windows. I'm only gonna work, I think, 3 more days, and then that's it for my first working summer. And I'm gonna have so much money, I'm not gonna know what to do with it. But it's been an experience. And then next week, Buck's coming, and we'll say hello to him, and we'll go to the Denver Grand Prix. And then after that, I'll go on my trip, which I think I'm pretty sure I mentioned earlier. And anyway, I don't know. You can just keep watching this tape, like, because it's so good. Anyway. I don't know. See, a lot of this, I think, is hilarious. I think this is a really funny tape. I mean, I haven't watched it. I've watched parts of it because, you know, you have to, like, rewind and see where you are and stuff. And I've watched parts of it, and I found them very funny, especially Kung Fu Man. But see, I think I might be a little too close to the humor. It's really tough to step back and be objective about something like this. So, it's entirely possible that you may not find this funny at all, nor will anyone else, but just keep your opinions to yourselves if they happen to be of that nature, because I think it's really funny. And you a funny guy, hey. A lot of it I know is pretty weak, but I mean, I just put it in just because, and what are you going to be doing? You're going to be waiting for like second antibodies to mature and ripen. You can watch videotapes. You got time for that kind of stuff. I don't. All right. I'm busy doing things. Things are happening. I'm going places, doing things. Look like a slouch on camera because I'm sitting down. If I put it too high, you get the light. You know, kind of an overcast day here in Denver. But, I'll bet you just yawned because, you know, yawns are contagious. Anyway, I'd like to tell you I miss you. I'd like to, but I can't because I don't. No, I'm kidding. But, you know, even if I did, I wouldn't tell you because that's rudely interrupted once again. But anyway, as I was saying, I would never give you cheese on camera because that's just blackmail material. And I don't know what you could do with that. So, anyway, I'll just say, sup, Bim. Hope you're making me brownies and stuff. Tough guy approach, you know. Just in case this tape falls into the wrong hands, we don't want anything incriminating on it now, do we? No. But, I don't know. I've had a fantastic summer, and I'm really sorry it's coming to a close, but I think that these final days are going to be some of the best, and it's a shame that we've got half, you know, that you can't share in them, because I know I'm going to be having a great time, and I hope you are too at whatever you're doing, and I hope Paul's really pleased with your work, and I hope everything works out well for Zavin. And I hope your parents, Mr. and Mrs. Keatley, are those your parents? I hope they're doing well too. And Big John, John boy, hope you're getting ready to come to Princeton. fella. Tell him that he can hang out, like, you know, with us and stuff. He can get a bad reputation like we have too. As troublemakers, fun guys, you know. So I think we've got that reputation on camp. No, amongst ourselves we do. Everyone else, like, I don't know, kind of rambling now, but, you know, I don't want to waste any tape. It's like a 7-hour tape or something. Well, it's not that long, but I mean, there's going to be a lot of blank space.
Ooh.
I should go back to bed. I'm tired because I was filming this thing all night. I'm having a good time. This year is going to be a great year. I'm really excited, except for the JP stuff. Anyway, and this is cool. You can just do a conversation. I mean, you're probably sitting there, Laura. You're watching and going, well, maybe he's going to say something after this that's important, so you keep watching. No, this is pretty much it. I'm just going to ramble for a while and keep you occupied. But, you know, it's just too bad, so. Having fun. Anyway, it's going to be weird, like, when you're watching this, because I'll have already done this and forgotten about it. And you'll be going, you're such a jerk at the end. As you are prone to do. And you'll be doing that. I don't know. So anyway, before this gets really boring, I guess I'll quit and mail it to you so you can watch it. I hope you don't have like a stereo VHS. Because if you do, the whole first half done in the basement. The basement? And we'll have that annoying stuff in the background. But all you have to do is just get a regular VHS, VCR, and listen to it. I'll explain it to you someday. I can show it to you in the morning.
I was born a poor black.
Well, it's time for me to fly. So, you know, someone told me at the beginning, they said, Matt, do a good shower, right? And I said,
yeah, okay.